Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the Department of Computer Science Engineering from Dr. MJR Educational Research Institute, I would like to welcome our session speaker, Mr. A. Gokulakrishnan, Junior Scientific Officer, Central Forensic Science Laboratory, Hyderabad. Really, we are proud to have you as one of the resource speaker for our session, sir. Thank you, and as well as it's really we feel very proud to have one resource person from CFSL, since it is related to our FDP title, cyber security. With this welcome, I just hand over the session to Dr. Rajakumar, professor in computer science and engineering department. Rajakumar sir, please take over the session.
Very good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, Rajakumar, sir, can you unmute your mic?
Very good afternoon to our special speaker and
good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir. And other all participants from all over India, ATAL AICT program conducted by CSE department of our Educational Research Institute. Very good afternoon once again. The session is about practical applications of forensics tools for examination and analysis of digital storage by our well-known Mr. A. Gokulakrishnan, Junior Scientific Officer. Department of Central Forensic Science Laboratory, Hyderabad, Directorate of Forensic Science Services by Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. Sir, working in the field of computer and mobile phone forensics since 2010. Sir, involved in the analysis of different digital storage media like mobile phones, memory cards, SIM cards, hard disk, etc. Using different forensics hardware and software tools like UFED, Encase Guidance software, Falcon, Tabulae, Forensics Toolkit, AutoSpy, etc. I once again welcome, sir. Now kindly request, sir, to take over the session, please. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you can proceed now.
Okay. Can you share the screen? Can you start?
Yeah, you can start now, sir, please.
Displaying host disabled participant screen sharing. It's displaying. Host, it is displaying that host display disabled participant screen sharing. Hello?
Yes, sir. Yeah, now we can try it out, sir. Please.
Okay, let me try again.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Fine.
Yes, please go ahead, sir.
The screen is visible?
Yes, sir. You can press it now.
Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon.
Yes, sir. Very good afternoon, sir. You can start.
Okay. Myself, Gokulakrishnan, working in Central Forensic Science Laboratory. And I am involved, already I said, it's involved in the analysis of the digital storage media using different forensic tools. If anything, interruption is there, and it is not audible, please do inform. Okay.
If anything else, I will let you know, sir. Okay, you can continue.
Okay. Just first, let me try to say what is forensic science. Okay, forensic science actually it involves in examination of different media or where the crime is involved, and we need to collect evidence, put it in document where the documentation or report will stand in the court of law. That's it. It may be involved in physics.
Sir, your voice is getting break.
Okay, it may be involved in the different field, maybe physics or computer forensic or ballistics like firearms.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Sorry for the interrupt.
Okay.
His voice is getting break.
Okay. Coming to digital forensics tools. Now is it fine?
Yeah, okay, sir. You continue.
Coming to digital forensic tools. This area is restricted to any digital storage media. Retrieval of data, as its title mentions, it is retrieval of data from any digital storage media like hard disk, mobile phones, SIM cards, or memory cards, and so on, using different software or hardware, it may be. What is digital forensics? Let me see. This, and specifically, it is generally called computer forensics. And nowadays, actually, the more crime is on mobile phone forensics. Earlier, it was called as digital forensics as well as computer forensics. Now, it is we call it as disk forensics or computer forensics and mobile phone forensics, both because more the technology is developing, everything is involved in the compact tool mobile phone, not like earlier as a laptop or computer. And this involves any crime if it has been done. Say illegally, I am taking the data of some other person, or illegally or sending unnecessary messages and are creating unnecessary disturbance to any third person. Then it involves into the involvement of crime, and the police comes into action, they file the FIR, the tools being used for committing the crime being seized, and it has been forwarded to our laboratory for to prove the evidence that so and so person involved in so and so crime, and such that it stands in the law of court. Coming to digital forensics, like in case we will see that one after another in detail, I'll be discussing what are the tools we are using in day-to-day life for retrieval of data. For there are different tools used for specific purposes. I've said digital cybersecurity or cybersecurity, these are coexistence. The more the cybersecurity is effective, then less the digital forensics. But nowadays, I think, as we know, the more intelligent, using very good technology, they are involved in crimes. That's what they are in pace with cybersecurity people. Those are involved in cybersecurity. They are in pace. Example, recently you would have,
Sir, your voice is getting break, sir. It's not clear, actually. It's getting flickering. Sir, are you there?
That fine. May I continue? Hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. His voice is getting. Voice is not clear. Actually, getting flickering.
Okay. Just hold on first.
Yes, sir, please.
Hello? Now is it audible?
Yes, sir, you can proceed.
Okay,
sir, can you go for a full slide mode, sir, in the PowerPoint? It will be better for us to reach out. Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir. Yes, sir. You can proceed now. Sir, your mic is on mute, I think.
Okay.
No, yeah, no. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think now, very interesting thing. Recently, you would have heard of in all the newspaper, it has come.
One of the very interesting... It's come to the normal mode, I think so. Can you resume the slideshow, please?
Fine.
Not at... Yeah. You can proceed now, okay. Sir. Please.
Yes. I think one of the intelligent, very intelligent person, well-educated. I think even graduated from, I think, IIT. He was involved in booking of fake Super Tatkal ticket when it was lockdown was going on. Then now you may think of how intelligent cyber criminal is when compared to the modern world. That's all. Actually, the more the cyber security keeps on enhancing and the more the intelligent is being involved in the commitment of crime, the more there is a demand for digital forensics. Now, I think you may understand cybersecurity and digital forensics, they are complement to each other. And main is the involved more the smartphones are sophisticated, plus the involvement of the highly intellectual persons in the cybercrime. And now you may understand the demand of the digital forensic in the present world. Now, what are the kinds of uses of digital forensics? As I said, he may be involved in criminal investigations of police investigation if they take into case and they forward the exhibit. I mean, it may be a hard disk or mobile phone or SIM card or memory card, whatever the digital storage media may be. He will be forwarding to us, then we will be proceeding for examination. Then it may be involvement of fraud, as maybe which occurs in financial fraud, generally nowadays financial fraud using fake applications like that. Am I audible now? Hello?
Yes, sir, you can proceed.
Okay. Then main is this, only very few people, this maybe they will be knowing. Copyright problem is there. See, when a cricket player is advertising for Byju's logo, then same I cannot hear without the knowledge of the player, logo of the Byju's or anything. This is actually as per law strictly, but this is being not taken care seriously. But as per law, I cannot use the logo of the Bata or Byju's on my t-shirt as I like. This copyright is there for everything. And espionage is actually cyber espionage. This is a very serious thing where some in defense related field or other fields where the intelligent person is working on some project or maybe his assistants or very close aid. He may access the data of whatever he has put his hard work without the knowledge of him. This is highly very serious thing. And if it is occurring in very, say, security related issues, and this is a very serious crime. This is called a cyber espionage or cyber spying. This acting very recently a news has come regarding this one. What we used to do, if it is, we are called for crime scene. If it are, we got not the evidences or exhibits or hard disk is brought to the laboratory. If we are, say, immediately as on the spot, we have been requested by the police to visit the crime scene and watch. We need to gather the evidence. And until then, it is the duty of the police to protect without any disturbance. Gather the evidence, then if necessary, the system is on, we need to take the data of the RAM immediately before we request the police to shut down and seal it, properly seal it and take it into the custody. And before we ask them to forward to our laboratory for further investigation, further examination. But critical information, it is mandated to check each and every point. What are the things we can gather before actually we come out of the crime scene spot? Then the police has to forward for analysis. Then the major work is analysis. We need to say which tool will be effective for which kind of exhibit and what is a query. Two different tools may be useful for retrieving the data, but which tool will be more effective for giving the output in a very better manner, such that will stand well before strongly in this court of law. that is documentation, presentation of the documentation and report, this is very vital. And this actually depends on the person to person, expert to expert. That's what the tools. Two or three different tools may be useful for retrieval of same kind of data, but it is up to the expert, expertise in the field, to decide which tool to use. And say, the evidence has been taken into custody of the police. Police sometimes, the matter is very serious thing. They take into the, what is that, take permission of the court. It may be judicial magistrate, or high court, even sometimes Supreme Court. So case goes to CBI. CBI takes the permission of Supreme Court. And before the next due date, they need to submit the report or report to the next, before the next hearing. That's it. First is the police or ourselves. Once it is, and if it is after reaching our lab, it should not say if it is CPU has come, generally it is very careful, and it's very careful in detaching the hard disk from the CPU and go for retrieval of the data. We never work on the original hard disk or any original storage media. And first is we need to take the image of the hard disk, imaging a hard disk. That I will tell you in detail how and what are the tools in further PPT. I'll tell you. Mishandle means never connect to this read-write mode. Do not connect any evidence in the system where we can write it. It must be always write block. Any evidence, if at all it is connected. Even if you go for imaging, you must take care that it is always being write block. Such that even a single bit or single bit of data provided in the original evidence is not disturbed. Operating system, you must be well aware of the tools which you are being using, which platform the system will support, or the tool which you are using, you must be already aware of before we start examining the tool with the present crime scene exhibit or crime exhibit. Then comes the documentation. Each and first, we need to photograph before we open the parcel, then photograph the exhibit, such that a serial number of the hard disk, or it may be serial number of the IMEI number of the mobile phone, make, model, everything we need to take care before we proceed for examination. The result should be repeatable. Say, if the forwarding authority or the police or court, they are not satisfied with the report of or myself, report of mine, then they can forward for re-examination to any other laboratory or any other examination, such that they may be well equipped, some other lab, and such that they may get some additional data. But whatever data I have retrieved, it must be repeatable. That's why we must be very careful in documentation and extraction of data. And it must be verifiable by third party. Third party means, I mean to say, it must, same exhibit is being, hard disk or mobile phone is being handed over to the some other lab or some other person, you should not get a different data for the same query. You may get additional data. Maybe you may have better tool or advanced tool or latest tool. But the data already which I have retrieved and submitted over to the police, that should be cross-verified. It must be cross-verified by any third party. That we must be, documentation, it is representation documentation, we must be very careful. This actually, earlier we have been saying computer forensic, digital forensic, both are same. But now more crime is on mobile phones. So audio is fine? Everybody, it's audible to everybody?
Yes, sir, you can proceed, sir.
Okay, that's it. If any interruption is there, please do inform me.
Yeah, I will let you know.
Okay. Mobile phone forensics becomes the most vital now. Because everybody, you can see anybody actually, even common citizen is with smartphone only nowadays. And then comes the hard disk forensics. There are some cardinal rules working on the, we will never work on the original exhibits, which as already informed. Always we will be imaging. Imaging, generally it is meant that in this context, it is forensic imaging. Forensic digital imaging. using digital forensic tools, imaging tools. There are 2-3 well-known, very good tools which is internationally used, and it is with us also. We also possess those tools. And we need to analyze or examine only on the image, not on the original exhibit. Never we actually, it is always requested not to work on the original exhibit or original hard disk. That's it. Data using digital forensic analysis tools. There are now coming to actual. What is the actual work we used to do? Any cyber expert used to do, if at all, say, exhibit means here I mean maybe hard disk, mobile phone, SIM card or memory card. Because generally I'm used with like that term, exhibit. That's it, please be understand that exhibit means it involves any of these. And evidence, sometimes evidence or image. That means it involves any of this. We actually go for imaging using two well-known tools are there, which is internationally and it can do very better, higher rate, data transfer rate is higher rate, Falcon and Tableau. Falcon, what are the facilities we have in that is, it can do imaging, that is forensic imaging, and it can do cloning. Cloning and imaging, it is difference is there. Cloning is just a mirror image. Say, hard disk is there, out of 500 GB, only 320 GB is occupied, and some data are there. And just, it is a Xerox copy, cloning. That facility is also there in this tool, Falcon. And imaging, it can retrieve additional data, apart from live data, which we call present data or live data. Apart from that, it can retrieve deleted data also, and sometimes even overwritten data also. This Falcon has the ability to retrieve. People think that, okay, our exhibit will be, our mobile phone will be seized, our hard disk computer will be seized, just to get it deleted and we are safe. Not that. This imaging tool is a very high-tech tool, and it can retrieve any deleted data, even overwritten data also. And other facility in this imaging tool is hashing. Hashing, I think you must be knowing. Say, when I take normal paper, photocopy, manually we will check, okay, everything is same, or we are giving to a third person and we ask him to take the photocopy, whether it is similar photocopy. It is similar. This hashing is hashing of the digital data. Even if one letter is changed in the particular storage media or the file, I can, using this one, I can create hash value for a single file or hash value for the whole storage media. And this hash value, you can call it as fingerprint of the digital media. Fingerprint. Yes, or we have, each and everybody has unique fingerprint like that. Hash values. And it can be re-verified in any genuine forensic imaging tool or any other expert on any other laboratory anywhere. And the hash value is, if it is same, that means the data is not even a space should not be. If space is applied between two words, then hash value will be very. A single letter is changed. Myself say Krishnan, KRISHNAN. Instead of that, just a single place out of some 800 words in the file, I am removing a single letter, then hash value will change. That means something somebody has edited. That's it. If hash value is same, it may be in different media copied into this from hard disk to memory card or a hard disk to DVD. If hash value is same, that means the data of the file is not at all disturbed. Then it's not necessary to worry. Only storage media is different. And Tableau is also the same function. Two different well-known, well-reputed tools are there for imaging. It can be used for imaging, cloning. Cloning is just mirror image, just a copy. And hashing. Hashing sometimes, IO, investigation officer used to, he may have that doubt on the one of the company person. And he would have retrieved hard disk from the owner and the employee of that company. Then he'll ask us whether both are same. And the owner would have complained, sir, he has taken the data from my personal computer. And he may actually, he would have copied the chemical formula of, he may be running the chemical factory, chemical formula. And he is planning to move out of my company and maybe he may start his own business. Please, you come and seize his laptop and you just go for. Then the police can take into custody of both. They will verify. They may ask for imaging, cloning, hashing, whatever they would like to do. Imaging, you would have all of a sudden employee, if you would have got information, you would have deleted also. Imaging, we can retrieve it. And through hashing, he may claim that the employee, no, sir, this I myself have created out of my own knowledge. But through hashing, after retrieval, through image, we will go for hashing. If it is same, then you can very well, police or IO or court will decide. Not even a single word has been changed. Then yes, actually, copyright or spying, you say, digital spying. He has done that. Then you will be behind bar. Maybe 3 years, 4 years, as per the nature of the crime. These two are Falcon and Tableau. If at all you want, you may take note of it. These two are imaging tools, cloning and hashing. All the facilities are there in this one. Now, other examination tools for analysis, examination, analysis and report generation. These are the tools, different tools, software tools we are using it. NCASE guidance software, magnet forensics, autopsy, access data forensic toolkit. There, among these, one or two are there, open source. Anybody can wish to download. After registering, they can download from their website and you may start practicing. It is not that everything is copyright and you need to pay for that. NCASE guidance, you need to, it is a licensed version. FTK also licensed version. Maybe autopsy is in open source. If at all anybody wants to practice, you may download it, register it, download it, and we start practicing using it. This also gives very good result, autopsy, which why I'm referring it is the open source tool. This all for examination of the imaging and examination of the hard disk and the memory cards. In either like pen drive, flash drive, anything. This last one, UFED, XRY, oxygen forensic suit, mobile edit SIM extractor. These are the tools which has been developed within India, and this has been developed by CDAC Trivandrum. Mobile edit. Mobile edit, at least it will give the light data in a legal report format. That is also, it can stand in the court of law. And SIM extractor, it also gives same result. Only thing is, tool is different. But UFED, XRY, oxygen forensic suit, all are legal. It's costly, but that may give very good result, even deleted everything. For extraction of, these are all for extraction of data from mobile phones, SIM cards. This NCASE, magnet forensics, autopsy, FTK, forensic toolkit, is meant for analysis and examination, analysis and report generation of the hard disk and memory cards. This UFED, XRY, oxygen, it is used for examination, analysis, and report generation of mobile phones. Mobile phones, generally, Android platform will be there. Sometimes iOS will be there for Apple phones. That's what it needs, a different tool. What is SIM? Can anybody say what is SIM? I think you people, we used to purchase quite from the market. Can anybody say what is SIM and what is the data? What is the SIM number? Is the SIM number same as mobile phone number? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can yes, anybody say SIM number yes. is same as mobile no, number?
No, yes, sir. You can proceed, sir. You can proceed, sir.
So SIM, sir, number is not the same as mobile number. It's different okay. number.
It is different number. Mobile number which you used to make is okay. It gets activated only after the network service provider enables. SIM number, where it is present, SIM number?
Sir, it is there present in the chip itself.
On the SIM card itself?
Right.
Okay. That I think if at all anybody out of interest, they would have checked how many digits are there. That is called
ICC. So barcode also.
Barcode also. Nowadays it is barcode also. Latest nano SIMs, it is with barcode also. ICCID number, that is technically called, digitally called ICCID, Integrated Circuit Card Identifier. Integrated Circuit Card Identifier, ICCID. That is generally 20 digits. Sometimes, for more security, you may see in any of the SIM cards, only 19 digits not more than that. It will be printed. This one way, because see, example, I'm a businessman. I can invest and create fake SIM cards. And I can disturb the company of some other, say, example, company, what is that, business of the some other firm like X or Y or any other ABCD. But to avoid that, more security is being incorporated in the SIM card. That's what generally this digits all will not be, though it is explicitly being mentioned, at least the 20th digit will not be displayed in that. This 20th digit, generally it is being generated based on algorithm. This, if at all you want, you can note it down. That is called Loon algorithm. LUHN, Loon algorithm. That is, I think, I may explain it, but it may take time. You may check in it. It is available. You need to double the alternate digits, given digits, then submit, and that's divided by 10. The last unit digit, you have to subtract from the 10, then whatever they come, that will be the 20th digit of the ICCID. That some formula is there. Okay, that you check in net, what is Loon algorithm? That is applied in different, not only in SIM cards, different fields, Loon algorithm. Is there any other number? Mobile phone, which we generally use it and give it to our friends, okay, for calling, mobile phone, ICCID. Is there any other number being incorporated inside the SIM card? Can anybody say any other number? Hello?
Yes, sir, we can hear you. We can hear you, sir. You can.
Okay. Listen. Apart from that, only these two numbers are there in the SIM card. Mobile phone, 10-digit number, and the ICCID number.
IMI yes. Number is all. That is a phone.
Yes, it is in mobile phone, madam. Mobile phone.
Yes, sir.
But we will come to later. In SIM card, one more number is there, which is never physically, we can physically view it. This is more security is intuitive here. Without that, see, I am involved in generation of fake, but a genuine SIM producer, maybe a Vodafone or Jio, they generate IM internet mobile subscriber identity, that is called. It is here, now you can see in screen, the second line, it is there, international mobile subscriber identity. They incorporate that 15-digit MSI number, and it is being, I think, one more thing. You know that as soon as you purchase the SIM card from the mobile phone, SIM from the any shop, after you just put in the mobile phone, talking to the incoming outgoing call is possible. As soon as you purchase and put in your mobile, not at all.
No, sir.
You need the verification from the service provider. You need verification from the service provider. There comes into picture of the originality of the SIM card or IMSI. They will say, I think they take documents while purchasing SIM cards. Then until it reaches the service provider, then it never gets activated. Then they cross check all the documents which are submitted. Then they say that, okay, is the original customer. Then they get the IMSI number of the SIM card is activated. Only then your SIM starts giving service for you, IMSI number. That is in the control of main network control, where the SIM card is being, SIM card data. Main ICC, you can 10 digits. Mobile phone number, SIM card, they used to tell you, and it may be even displayed in the cover itself.
Sir, your voice is getting break, sir. Your voice is getting break.
Is that audible? Now?
Now you can proceed, sir.
Okay. And it comes now, IMSI important, other than this one, IMSI, where the vitality of the IMSI is, it protects the originality of the SIM card. Not that it is easy, or you can generate or disturb the business. It is not at all possible. They have the unique data for this mobile phone, which the customer, each SIM card has a unique mobile phone and the ICC number. And it should tally with the IMS number. This has been generated while manufacturing the SIM card itself. If these three are matching, only then your service gets activated by the service provider. This IMSI number is inbuilt within the SIM card itself. There are some algorithms are there. And this is part of the algorithm. IMSI number is there within the SIM card. And without that, if the IMSI number is not tallying with the server or database of the service provider, then your SIM card never gets activated. Neither you can make incoming or outgoing. There are different SIM cards you may be knowing. ALS one was like close to actually, which is modern day debit card. Then it come to normal SIM cards, mini SIM cards, now nano, micro, nano, everything. Micro has, now wide uses micro. Now this, you may read what I have already discussed, it is here. If people want, anybody wants, please, you may note it down. SIM card contains its unique serial number, ICC ID, and International Mobile Subscriber Identity, IMSI. What are the details present inside and outside of SIM card? These three, four lines, it will help you. If at all you want, you may note your ICC ID number, which is present over the SIM card, an IMSI, which is inbuilt within the SIM card, authentication and ciphering information, it involves in network service, and temporary information. That is more vital when actually criminal moves from one person to another person. That is our location. We call it as local area network. When keeps on moving, the police is chasing him. Then based on that only, I think police actually with their tower location, they will track him. Local network. That they, the police should tie up the service provider. ICCID, this already I have discussed. It is a generally 20 digits, but to make more effective and secure, it is generally 19 digits are printed over the SIM card. The last digit is called check digit, single digit, calculated from other digits, all the 19 digits, which is already present using the Loon algorithm. SIM cards are identified on the individual operator. Individual operator varies from service provider to service provider. Unique IMSI. This is like us biometric, it is IMSI. Every SIM card is unique IMSI number. Mobile operators connect mobile phone calls and communicate with their market SIM cards using their IMSI, International Mobile Subscriber Identity. Now, is that so far about SIM cards we have discussed? Everything is fine? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That's what. Only three, four details are there in the SIM card, but still you need to make a note of it. ICC ID, IMSI, the mobile phone will be there. Then network data will be there, which is temporarily stored. That may be retrieved using our tool. That what tool and retrieve, that we will discuss later slides. Now, one of the madam said IMEI, International Mobile Equipment Identity. IMEI is present on the mobile phone. This has happened, it may be quite costly. Always it is better to register, because he may be misusing. The person who has stolen your phone, apart from your last financial loss, if he is misusing for some crime, then your name will come into picture. Always better you register your phone with this brand, in which brand you have purchased, company. And once it is lost, you may complain, make a complaint to the service provider, and they may blacklist. With the help of the police, they may actually, with the use of the IMEI number, they may track the phone, they may get it back, or worst case, they will blacklist. Blacklist means the service provider. Not only they say, if you have been lost with your Airtel SIM card, then Airtel service provider can immediately blacklist. Wherever the SIM card is used, they will block that SIM card. If that you have been informed properly, the police is continuously monitoring, that phone can be disabled forever. At least you'll be safer from that. It is your mobile phone is not being misused. So nowadays, I think we must be very careful. If at all, not only financial loss, if the crime is being made on your phone, which is registered on your phone, then you are also in trouble. That please make sure that once your phone is lost, make a legal complaint. If it is lost. Hashing, it is like fingerprint. Fingerprint already, I have been discussing a few minutes before. There are different hashing algorithms. MD5 is there, MD5 hashing, which is 32 bits, hexadecimal bits. SHA-1 is there, secure hash algorithm. This is MD5's message digest algorithm. SHA-1 is secure hash algorithm. Secure it will be. If it is SHA-1's message digest, highly intelligent people, sometimes they try to manage that MD5 matches, but they may disturb at least one or two bits. Say value instead of 1 million, it is means maybe credited, he gives a letter, employer owner to the somebody, and he may remove one, he may add one more digit. Then there are intellectual digital crime, it is called. And more to incorporate more security, SHA-1 is incorporated all the others to be more secure. Whenever we generate hash algorithms, we all generate MD5 minimum SHA-1 or SHA-256 apart from MD5. Sometimes we generate, if it is based on case to case or vitality of the file, only one file they may ask out of 7 lakh files. See, they would have forwarded one hard disk and it may contain approximately 7 lakh files. They will ask only one image. Sir, image of this credit card is present in there or not? Only one query will be there. This actually, based on query, we can actually minimize our time. It is not that digital crime. It is very effectively done. Examination is, you can sit and work in your system. You can generate the report. Not that it is not that much, so much easy. It is time consuming and sometimes you need to break your brain. 7 lakh files and just query will be only one query. But you need to check all the images, maybe in different forms, JPG, JPEG, PNG, everything. To track only the photograph of the credit card. That is not that actually people think that it is just user-friendly, just work on the software and just report will be generated using the tool. And you can produce the report. Some they used to say, and many used to think like that. Not that. See, queries, there is one case which it has involved. They were asking photograph of, see, it is actually POCSO case, child crime case. Just there was one case, one image where both were together and it was deleted. Father of the girl complained, but I never knew this, that boy. Then it was there. But that was containing more than 32,000 images. But it took time. But still we got it and he is now gained bar. Only one picture, it made him. It changed his life. This, you may read that one. Aldis and Bob have two similar huge files, maybe some 200 pages file. How do you know that they are different without sending them to each other? Both, they cannot read 200 pages together, but they want to check that their files are different. Just you create hash value for your phone file, create hash value, let X create hash value for her file, Y create hash value for his file. Then if hash values are different, automatically, if it is, they are different, contents are different. Actually, please be understand, some people think that there are document, 17 pages are there. I've taken some vital document of somebody, X, from his system, and I've changed the file name. And I'm using it in my system. But I've taken from some third person system. I've changed the file name. They think that, okay, nobody will know, come to know. Not that. There are tools, techniques, hash, it generates based on the only content of the file, not the name of the file. Please take a note of this one. Only content of the file. If you change, you may edit 100 times of the file name. But if the content is same, hash value will be same, then the copier, who is the second user, he'll be always in trouble. Okay, you cannot claim that it's my, see, file name is different. It's my own file. See, this generally it happens when you create a thesis or many users, they download files or publications from different foreign authors, copy, paste, edit, repeatability. That is also there where crime has come. Keyword search are there, one of often in NKS. Keyword search, that search was there. The original author has complained. Say, this is mine. And we found that there is one word or 6-7 words which he was frequently asking, using in that publication. But the copier, the student, who is currently doing, now she is banned from continuing her education for next 4 years. This is an actual case. Based on keyword search, we have found that in document of this original author, these words are being used. The same, which actually it varies from individual to individual. And there's all these 7 files, all these 7 words, it has been reoccurring in the copier, the second user, almost same number of times. This, we have reproduced the report, and it stood against her, this copier, second user. Now she is unable to continue her education for next 4 years. This is one of the last year's case, 2020. Yes, it may be made 2020. There is one option in NKS or other tools also, all of the tools where we can go for keyword search. I think we need to compare two different data, or else based on it is out of experience it comes. What are the words we need to give for keyword search? Repeatability of algorithm. Say they want just a copy of the, sometimes they ask, DGP asks, just he needs one more copy of the whatever data I have extracted. You can forward the letter to our director. Director, then he may give, then I need to give, apart from quote, the quote which I have received directly, I can give to the DGP. But whenever it is being checked, cross-checked in any other software, say I am actually using Falcon for imaging. An example, if you are sticking in tab, or even imaging is possible in FTK also, not necessary that, but it will take time, consume time. Only imaging tools can complete the imaging in 2 hours. It may take 12 to 14 hours in imaging case, imaging tools. Certain, there are some tools in which we can do all the works, imaging plus analysis plus report generation. Imaging, analysis, and report generation. NK6, NK8, both are fine. Latest versions in FTK is there. You can do all the works. Only this, why specifically there are hundreds of cases with us, just we need to complete the work at a rapid rate. That's what it has been exclusively the digital forensic field itself generated specific tools manufactured for only imaging. That kills our time like anything. Only imaging is completed, then we can start analyzing, examining on the image of the original evidence. That's it. It has been, now it has come into picture the last few years only, I can say, last 4 or 5 years, where the imaging tool has taken the more vitality, and it is saving our time, a lot of time. Because it may get hanged. System may get hanged if RAM is low. And it may kill our time, and we cannot use our system for other works. That's it. Just we connect one evidence to imaging, and in that Falcon or Tableau, parallel imaging is possible. We can connect 2 original hard disks on the left hand side and right hand side. It will keep on imaging parallel. Not only 1, 2, any version. It may be SATA hard disk or ID or pen drive or memory card. USB ports are also there, and interface cables are there for connecting SATA and IDE. That I'll show you the pictures. Coming to mobile forensics. What are the data or likely data the IO or the court expects to retrieve? This generally address book, contacts, or call history. That's call logs. Generally, call logs, incoming, outgoing. What is the timing? What is the duration of talk? And SMS, MMS. These, I think you can see documents. It may be Word format or PDF, whatever. Web browser history. Now this UFED, I think just I'll give one introduction about UFED. Everybody is listening? Please. Can I carry on?
Yes, sir. Hello? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, that's it. Yes, just okay, that's it. Yeah. I need to just press click on the other side, but that's it. Now, web browser is history, then email. These are all after usage of smartphones in the present world. This has come into more importance. Earlier, it will be worst case call logs, SMS, not even MMS in the earlier version till 2010, I may say. After then, it started coming photos and videos. Now, more queries on after call logs, emails, web browsing. These have come into picture. Social networking, that you say WhatsApp, that to deleted WhatsApp details. Is now more query will be on any of the, it will be because that it is out of social networking. This is actually social application. This is the number one used, even not only in the broad world. WhatsApp, it will be deleted and they may ask retrieval of WhatsApp and what are the contents of it being either incoming or outgoing, it may be. And they may ask from this number to that number, and if it is present, what is the details of the file? That is called metadata. If at all anybody actually, it is called metadata. Metadata means file name, then path, in which location of the phone it is present, then date of creation, date of modification, date of deletion, all details of the file you will get. And deleted data. Now coming to this, I think these are the details generally we can retrieve using that our UFED tool or any other XRY oxygen forensics tool. Generally, actually widely used is universal forensic extraction device. This is a little introduction I'll give about UFED. UFED, this being manufactured by Celebrate company, it is an Israel company. I think you may be knowing it's a very small company, but Israel company. Which UFED device, it's cost around minimum of 10 to 12 lakhs. Starts minimum, basic. If it is more facility you need to extract all the social networking data, generate report, physical analyzer, it will be close to 40, 45 lakhs each, every tool. For evidence to be, rules of evidence. For evidence to be admissible, it must be authentic. You need to follow a specific standard procedure, not that you connect the mobile on this side and take the data on the pen drive or memory card or hard disk on that side and give it back. It must be authenticated and complete, reliable and believable. Complete, reliable, like this must be actually, there should be authentication and reliable from source of the file and date of extraction. Who has extracted, what tool have used, and what is the version of the tool, software. And hardware means what is the name of the tool I've used, or what is the version. Everything in report generation, everything will be displayed such that even non-technical person will come to know, oh, it is a genuine report. The police, he may be a generally non-technical background. He will see, okay, report has been generated by so-and-so, name of the expert, and date, and which tool being used, and the file name, where was the file present. He may check this file would have been retrieved from some other exhibit, but the exhibit model number, IMA number, everything will be present in the report. then not necessary to send a second person, test, sir, this is the authenticated report and this report is being from the exhibit forwarded only. Everything will be present in the report. It's not at all necessary for a non-technical person, anybody to cross check. Everything will be generated in the report. This is actually advantage is there, a present version of UFED. This great. It's a complete extraction of existing. Existing means live data, hidden data also there, deleted data, majority queries will be on deleted data.
Sir, some more
largest library of sub.
So sorry for the interrupt. Some your voice is cutting break actually.
Okay.
That is not stable, I think so. Can you please check it off? No, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, please. No, sir. Again, it's getting flickering.
Fine. Now, is that audible? Hello.
Sir, now it's okay, sir.
Can I continue?
Yes, sir.
Continue. Yes, can I continue?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Okay. You had actually now it is used widely used and it is more advantageous when compared to other for digital forensic tools. This is specifically meant for mobile phones, SIM cards. This can be used for extraction of data from memory cards also and pen drives also. All the four. And it can support different platforms, not only Android phones, Windows-based, iOS, Apple phones, BlackBerry, all the platforms it can support. Fake mobile phone. You can see same Samsung model. Somebody may say, I just purchased for 2,200 from some market. Because there are fake mobile phones are there. It will immediately, after I feed the IMEI number of this phone, in search devices, there is option in search devices in celebrate UFED. It will immediately tag into fake Samsung and what is the model. Everything it will do. Just I need to feed the IMEI number. It is that all you can support all the platforms of the mobile phones till Android. For live data, it can till Android 9, 10, it can retrieve. For deleted data till Android 8, so far, whatever I have used, it can retrieve deleted data, overwritten, everything. That's all. iOS till 7, it can retrieve deleted data. Because this actually, we need to update it again for actually present version. Because this actually is 3 years before, still we need to update it for the present. i12 have come. This we need to update it, but it can give even this can support different platforms. But it is one of the advantage is UFED, Android, iOS. Then majority of the crimes we receive only these two platforms, and not only mobile phones. This can extract data from SIM cards also. All brands and all it may be nano SIM, micro SIM, or normal size, and memory cards also, pen drives also. Memory cards, but we need to take care the card reader is there and it is always write blocked. Card reader specifically it is there for memory cards, different size memory cards you would have used in day-to-day life. Then option is there, which actually is a little bit costly, that we need to make it as write blocked before we go for extraction data from the memory card. This it can support all this. Support largest library of supported contents. The report generation, this is where it is actually makes different from other tools. The report, it will be very good and it will be user-friendly and any judge or any third person or IO can understand easily. And all the details, whatever he is expecting, it will be, everything will be available in the report. It is a dedicated tool and secure data extraction. Okay, same mobile phone. If it has been examined again by myself, say I feel that some more data can be present and I want to re-examine after 1 week, then it is that I need to get the same output from the same exhibit. Apart from that, only date of extraction will vary. It must be, everything else will be same. Date of extraction automatically will regenerate itself. That I cannot change. Then automatically, whichever is better, then I'll decide if at all. Most of the time, there are bypassing tools are there for password lock. I can go by bypass method. That it is necessary in sometimes if mobile phone is locked. And fast, it is actually fast and simple extraction process, this UFED. What are the procedures being used? We need to photograph the parcels, exhibits, IMEI numbers, ICCID for SIM cards, and what are the serial number present over the memory cards, everything before we sit for. Because while standing in the court of law for evidence, only our documentation will, apart from soft copy, one more copy we will be having with us. Then our documentation will stand. Okay, this is what exactly the exhibit I have examined, sir. And this is on so-and-so date. I can, should anybody, whomever it has been demanded, officially it has been demanded, then I can show. This is a photograph of the exhibits which I have examined. On so-and-so date, I have examined. Then I will have my own report. And it should tally with the report which I have forwarded. Everything will be there. Regarding RAM, that if at all sometimes it is on spot, crime scene visit is there, then we need to capture the RAM and then allow the IO to shut down this system. Nowadays, to examine the mobile phones, smartphones specifically, there is option, flight mode is there, right? Flight mode, you need to put in flight mode as soon as you start your switch on mobile phone in your laboratory. You need to put your mobile phone in the flight mode. Only then you start checking what are the details present and what cable you need to use it, everything. First put in the flight mode such that no incoming call or what is incoming messages it can receive. You need to put in flight mode before you start using it. Earlier, this facility was not there in normal phones, but the Faraday bag was used. Because it has to be in switched on condition, there is no facility in flight mode, and Faraday bag, this it can prevent any extra messages or whatever SMS to reach that. Faraday, it must be processed into the Faraday bag, only then you connect to your device for extraction of data from the mobile phone. Now flight mode, apart from that, you need to settings, you may see that one facility is there, USB debugging. You need to put your mobile phone in debugging mode, only then your UFED or other any other tool will start extracting data from the mobile phone. You need to put your flight mode, mobile phone in flight mode, or debugging mode. If it is not, then automatically your UFED will warn you. Put your mobile phone in debugging mode or switch on the debugging mode. A display will be there. If these two is mandatory, flight mode, or else your data may be corrupted or it may be disturbed. If you do not put your, as soon as you switch on your immediate next second itself, just put your mobile phone in flight mode. Here, now, I think, now I was boring. Now you may see the real picture of the UFED. This is what UFED Touch 2. Version is 7.4. What are the facilities? It was available. Now just go through it. Mobile devices, SIM cards, UFED camera is also there. Sometimes the criminal, very intelligent, where the port it is, we can connect from the mobile to the UFED device. you will destroy the port. Then it is legally allowed. If the UFED camera, you can take the snapshot. After you switch on the phone, if it is live data, then UFED camera, it can feed into the UFED after capturing the image from the mobile phone, then generate report for the particular image. That means, which phone was used for imaging, capturing the image, date of capturing. That is, you call the metadata of the file. Metadata of the file or metadata of the image file, whatever it may be, document file or image file. SIM card, mass storage, even sometimes you can pen drive, it may be 128 GB. This also can be examined. Then drone they used to forward. This comes from security point of view. This memory card, generally they insert the memory card. Then we need to detach the memory card and put it in the write blocker mode and connect it to this UFED and can generate the content of the memory card. This drone, sometimes we used to receive this. This version, Celebrate Touch 2 version, this is compact and it can support mobile phones, SIM cards, memory cards. This one, this is a SIM slot. This SIM slot, all the three slots are there. Normal, micro, nano, all the three slots are there. And you can just move on for selecting. Once it is connected, automatically this will be highlighted. Then you go for generation of the data from the SIM cards. Can I move to next slide? Hello? Can I move to next slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's it. If at all you are actually, then this also, this is what actually UFED I was talking about. And this is for SIM slot, the inner side. And this is actually for select, which is nano or micro and normal SIM, just proceed for extraction of data. This is after generating the output from the UFED, this device, our file, output file will be in UFDX format. It will not be reader friendly format. That file, you may copy it. You need to connect then the other side. Right side, the output, it may be in a hard disk, you can connect it. USB ports are on both the sides. The extraction of a SIM card or mobile phone, we can take it in a hard disk. That you need to connect it to the system in which this software is installed. This is also part of the UFED. The Celebrate used to provide both. That is a logical extraction we used to call, and this is physical analyzer where you can generate report according to the query. Physical analyzer. This is also 7.4. Version is 7.4. That is a logical extraction. This is physical extraction. This, because there may be several files, which is irrespective of the crime. His personal data may be there, but there may be only one bank statement, which date, and see, he may be a normal employee. He would have got deposited some 2 lakh amount into his. They will just ask for only that page. Not necessarily that all these 7,000 files are there. It is not required. Only according to the query, just we'll go for. And it may be in generally, if it is snapshot, we'll go for image. Image file, there will be category will be there after it is generating the physical analysis report. If it is image file or document file, PDF file, everything, just we need to go on categorizing and just spot that particular file and generate report only for that file. Not necessary to create report for it, will be then pages and pages, and it is irrespective of the crime committed. Now, just go through this one. This will be quite interesting. The actual report of the SIM card. Take some time. Now you can cross check. SIM card, the service provider, ICCID number is there. IMSI number is there, which is not physically viewable by us, but this UFED will report.
Sir, again, your voice is getting back.
It's unique for. Okay. This is UFED report of SIM card. This, can you view this report of CPAT?
Yes, sir, it's visible, but your voice is getting little
okay,
bit.
Okay. This report, this you will get all the particulars of CPAT. ICCIT number, IMSI number, and service provider name. Service provider, Airtel service provider, it is clearly maintained about the device information. Then here, coming down, same slide coming down. See that messages. There are 31 messages being retrieved by this tool. All the 31 messages are deleted. Within packet, red color, it is being highlighted. All the 31 messages, deleted messages are being retrieved. And timeline, all the time, nine are retrieved. Timeline, it comes to the contacts. This you can go through it. What are the details? The now comes the originality, which SIM it is being forwarded, and what being extracted. Main is comes to the contents of the SIM card. Apart from device information, which date, which SIM card we have used it for report generation, and what is the details of the data being retrieved. Now coming to working of SIM card, I think now you've got
sir, sorry for the
idea,
sir.
Right?
Sorry.
Yes.
Again, voice is getting break actually. Can you please?
Hello?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can proceed, sir. Your voice is getting break, I think so. Your voice is not clear.
Hello? Is that audible?
Yeah, please, sir.
Audible now?
Fine. Yeah, okay, sir. Okay, sir. Continue.
Okay. Yes. I think report on SIM card, I think. Can I move to the next slide?
Yes, sir. You can proceed now.
Okay. Now, I think regarding SIM card, you would have got some idea. What are the details present in the SIM card? It has been retrieved, generated in report format.
Space optical communication. But this is a small prototype.
What, sir?
Hello? Sorry, you can continue. You can continue. Sorry, some interruption.
Now, coming to the working condition, what is the procedures being adopted for mobile phones, extraction of data from mobile phones? Yes. Firstly, it has to be any evidence which must be photographed before opening the parcel, and it has to be exhibits or mobile phone exhibits, refers to any storage media. It is photograph and serial number. We need to documentation, photograph. Then once we start examining, we need to be put in flight mode, then debugging mode. Only then UFED will recognize your mobile phone. This actually, one more thing is, sometimes security lock, we used to give locking into mode within 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 1 minute, option will be there, lock mode. But it's always advisable, because UFED will keep on giving some, generating some instructions, and that will be, we need to tap on the screen of the mobile phone. Always go to the sleeping mode, never, or else stay awake, always. These three you need to take care before you start your examination. Flight mode, USB debugging mode, and stay awake. This, because some instructions it may generate, depends, varies from mobile to phone, mobile and model to model. That it is required that it is never goes to sleeping mode. The mobile never goes to sleeping mode during extraction of the data from the mobile phone. Then if the same model of the mobile phone is present, say it may be Samsung or Nokia or whatever it may be, then automatically just after connecting into the input side of the UFED, immediately, it not necessary that you need to go to Samsung. Within Samsung, 70 models may be there. Then you need to track one after another, then spot that model, then press it. Only then you can. It will kill your time. This UFED, it will automatically detect. Model is present in UFED. Already it is inbuilt. M21, say it is a model. And if it is already present, UFED, present version, automatically it will, yes, M21 will display on the screen. Not necessarily you need to search manually. It is that much advanced nowadays. The tools being manufactured. If model is not there, the other options are there for extraction. that we'll discuss file system advanced logical. The model is there. Then physical extraction, very well, almost it is compatible with almost all the Android phones. For iPhone, still iPhone 7, it is fine. Other things, at least live data we can retrieve. Other higher version iPhones and Android latest last 1 year, which has been released in last 1 year, we can check live data. Till 2019, it can retrieve all the, whatever the version has come, Android. Physical extraction is done, then our job of extraction data, all the data, including all the data means live data, send data, delete data. Then that is fine, physical extraction. Most 95% of the mobiles what they forward, sometimes this Redmi few phones, latest models which has been released, the models are not there, but still we can manage. Other options are there, file system, advanced logical are there. Other options, there are three different kinds of extraction. That actually is the nearest model we used to connect it, and you can go for other options, nearby models, and it will support it. This UFL will support for extraction. You can sometimes it may get only minor difference will be there in hardware of the models. We can even retrieve the deleted data also. 100% you can generate the live data, and you can give the official report. That is always, it will, once the report has been generated in the PDF format, that will stand in any court. Physical extraction, file system extraction, advanced logical. File system extraction, it will be helpful in browsing related history and installed applications. Installed applications, sometimes query will be there. Apart from data, use that zone's application for committing so-and-so crime. Say money transfer, nowadays we are receiving a news also, right? Money related, loan related applications are being installed. Then query may be there, whether this application has been installed. Though we may be knowing, but that whatever he says orally, the police or IO, it will not stand in the court. Illegal. It needs official report. Then it may come to this reports. Then date of installation, what is the version of the application? The details of complete details of the application will be there. Date of installation, the mobile also will be generated. And all the installed applications, physical extraction, file system extraction will be there. Physical extraction, it is there. This extraction method we do for the phone data extraction. Request files from the phone, such as live data, hidden, deleted, overwritten data. But this process is time consuming. This, it is there. If inbuilt phone memory, now it is 120 GB is there. Common. And you would have been using for last 1.5 years. There would have been so many deleted data, overwritten data. Sometimes, according to the query, there would have been 10 to 15 queries. And we need to go for all the three kinds of extraction. For single phone, it may take even 2 days, only for logical extraction. Then physical analyzing, it will take some time. If query is very clear and it is precise, then fine. Or else, it will be time consuming. File system, locks will be there. System files and locks. When he has browsed that file, or when he has visited that browser, all the details will be there. Internet related database will be there, very well defined in file system. That's what sometimes, if it is web related query, we always go for all the three kinds of extraction. Though we get all the data, still not to lose any of the single file evidence, we need to do all the three kinds of extraction. It may be physical file system for that single mobile, such that not even a single file is missed. If it is internet related, browsing related, then file system extraction, it will always help. Additional informations. When he has visited the browser, what browser, whether Mozilla or Google Chrome, sometimes they may ask whether he has logged into this. But that also date we can retrieve. Yes, he has logged in. file structure, web browsing history. This application history and web browsing history, this actually additional data we can get from file systems. This advanced logical is it is quickest, easy, but sometimes it is additional better to use. It is according to the nature of the query we used to take it. If only so and so data, only this is they are asking. Say whether yes, purchased using this card and that actually photograph of that particular card is there, then it is very well actually we could see in physical extraction itself, then job is done. This we used to generate, point out that particular file, generate report for that. Job is done. That's it. And it will be location will be there, whether it is in which part of the. This. Can you see this slide? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can proceed.
This one, which I was telling, if the model is available in that, it is auto direction. It is saying enable developer options, USB debugging, developer options. But it is clearly mentioned. This only analysis. It will vary from expert to expert. If model is present, then this one not a big issue for logical extraction. If model is present, yeah, I think one can get well-versed with this one for within a month. Usage of UFED within a month. Build number will be there within settings. Because everything is within settings of the mobile phone, smartphone. Stay awake. Whatever I've said, it is there. Auto lock. Everything this you need to do before. And if your model is there present in UFED, automatically it will detect the model. Then you can proceed with the extraction of data. Now, this is what model I was searching for. SM215. It is there. Immediately it has come. SM215. At the right hand, it is there. Can you see? SM215. This is what they say. One day I was connecting it and immediately it was displaying. It may be 70, 80 models within Samsung SM. But once the model is present, it will immediately, within next few seconds, it will display yes. Then you select that one. Yes, touch screen. Everything is touch screen, user friendly. It's UFED. Yes, you need to select that one, then go for extraction of data, logical extraction. Can I move on? Hello? Can I move to the next slide?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can proceed, sir. You can proceed, sir.
Okay. Now these are all user friendly, it will be, and moreover interesting. All theoretical, which I was describing earlier and discussing, everything you can view there. Advanced logical, file system, physical routing method is there. These are all, I think, ones you need to practically and use this tool, then you will come to know what is routing. This is required when you are unable to retrieve some data, then routing method is there. It is chances are there you may get a retrieval of that particular file. It may be even overwritten file. At least minimum that you will. There is one option there: routing and parsing. Parsing, that word actually is a technical word. Parsing. At least the location it will highlight that some document or some file, some content was there in that location of the mobile phone. That means something he has deleted, though it would have been overwritten. Then always there will be 100% doubt on the particular processor of the mobile phone. Routing and parsing, these two options we used to do. If at all that file, he is a very intelligent person, he has even overwritten, but still again, so-and-so location, some data was present, and so-and-so date, it was deleted. That metadata we can find, a description of the file. File name, date of creation, deletion, everything will be there. Content, at least few digits will be in hexadecimal format. Something. Then there will be always doubt on the user. Then there will be further inquiry on him. Though the actual content may not be visible. This, at the extreme end, we used to go for this. If the file, particular file is iOS asking, not able to advance logical or file, it's not possible. Then we used to go for routing, in physical routing method, or parsing. this examination analysis in the UFRED. The extraction already I said it will be in UFDX format only. Another spot dot UFDX file in physical analyzer and bootloader. Bootloader is there means in it is done. UFDX means physical extraction is done. Model, see this is showing ITIL ES41. Then we can connect it to the physical analyzer and generate report. That UFRED report of mobile phone. I think I am running short of time. Little bit, I think I may move faster. UFRED report, Android ID is there, and detected manufacturer is ITIL. This is UFRED report of mobile phones. Model, everything is there. ICCID numbers are there. This is very vital. I have not connected any SIM card into this mobile phone, but still it is displaying ICCID, three ICCID numbers in this mobile phone. That means that SIM card was being used in this mobile phone. This actually, it is a very interesting case. That SIM card he has used for committing crime, and but he had doubted that he may be in trouble. He destroyed that SIM card. But they could see only the mobile phone. This report actually very well stood against that criminal, and he was punished. This ICCID number, it gave that this SIM has been used by him, the so-and-so criminal, in this using his mobile phone. And he is the owner of the phone. This is the report is actually still, I could recall, it's a very interesting report. It destroyed the SIM card, but this is showing. These SIM cards he has used in his own mobile phone. And these are the deleted data which we could retrieve. Call logs, how many deleted? See, text messages out of 1,095, 1,092 were deleted data. Text documents, all the two were deleted. Applications, almost all applications. He has actually almost has deleted everything before they could seize, the police could seize. Falcon imaging tool, this already have it, and output formats will be in either E01 or IMAGE DD. Anyone you can use it. E01 is compatible with any of the software, either in case for analysis, in case or autopsy or FTK. This is Falcon tool. Now please, everybody, take the time, few seconds. How the hard disk is connected. The left side, one SATA hard disk is connected with the interface cable. I think one more cable is there, which is not being used. Presently, we are imaging only one hard disk. And the right side is the bank hard disk, which is connected for transferring the image of this content of the hard disk. This is the original hard disk. Left side is original hard disk, this bank hard disk, in which the image will be generated. Now you can read what are the options in the Falcon tools. Falcon tool imaging is there. Hashing is there, verification is there. Verification means it will re-verify the hash being generated in the first instance. If both are matching, acquisition hash, it is called acquisition hash value on first, as soon as the image is being generated. And verification hash value is match, that means whatever the image of generated is 100% correct. Then you can carry on with the analysis. Wipe format is also there. If you want to format your user disk and wipe, and totally it will be 00 in all the bits will be 00. This is after verification, this is a report. This here you can see that as well is 4E5, last three digits. Again, verification 4E5. There are 291, two different as well is I was using MD5 and SHA-1 is matching. That means my imaging is fine. It took, what is the duration? It will be showing. Everything it will be showing. Duration 2 hours, 39 minutes it took. Here. Partitions, how many partitions were there? And source hard disk serial number and destination hard disk serial number will be there. Both serial numbers will be there. This is also part of, everything will be there after imaging. This is a Tableau. Earlier, we have been seeing Falcon, now Tableau Imager. Almost similar, Tableau Imager. Now coming to NKS guidance software, used for analysis and generation of report. Can I proceed?
Yes, sir. Hello? You can proceed, sir.
That's what. That I think. I was saying, you need to connect your image after creating image using Falcon or Tableau, and it will go for uploading of the image. Then, according to the query, if keywords that specific, say his name, files bearing his name, it is selected criminal. Then we'll give his name, or he may be using different names in different places for committing crime. They may give that clues. He was using so-and-so crime in so-and-so city, then so-and-so name on his own name. Then all the names we used to give, we can retrieve all the files wherever it has been occurring, out of even lakhs of files. File metadata can be generated. Internet artifacts means browsing history. Artifacts, browsing history. When did he browse the, and what kind of browser he has used, and how many times, all the log files will be there. All the facilities are there, including deleted files, documents, everything will be there. In case this can be generated using NKS. This is what. This is actually one of the memory card or pen drive just I have connected. And this occurring means it is image. I can image within NKS. That's what I want to say. In case you can, while creating image of the hard disk, say 1 TB generally, then it will take 10, 12 hours, 15 hours sometimes. It depends on how many files and how many deleted files. This occurring for pen drive and memory cards, we can image in NKS itself. Can finish within half an hour or 20-30 minutes. This is hash value. Each and every file, hash value is generated. On right side, right bottom, you can see what are the options are there. Deleted files, just if you click, all the deleted files will be displayed. Files after, because we very well know that this man came into picture only after so and so date. And this file was, I will be writing in his file. This file was, sir, this time was done after so and so date. Then we can filter it. We can remove files after date means it will neglect all the files it has been created before that date. Or so and so date, before date, all the options are there. Or between 22 days. Unique files as well means, say sometimes same file will be present in C drive, D drive, or other drives also, on same drive, different folders. And why to break ahead and waste our time on same content? Any filter hash value means though name will be different, content is same, and not necessary to go on for repeating same content. But that it will keep only one file, first occurrence file in the display. It will second, third occurrence of the same content will be not displayed. Then that's it. It will save our time. Unique files may actually because. Every file as it, if content is same, and file it will be same. Report generation after selecting the particular file, you can generate report that file scenes. This using other software, which I was saying is open source. You cannot register and download, you can start using this one. Autopsy. New case, which is already opened and closed, recent case we can. Database of that file. This one, see, left side you can see what are the categories of the files. It is displayed, image files, video files, image files, five files were there. It is displaying after the image has been uploaded. It is being processing. In this autopsy, we call it as ingest. See, credit card. These are the keywords such as I was giving. All the phone numbers, IP address, email addresses, credit card numbers. On left side, you can see what are the categories of the files. Audio files, video files, documents, everything. Image, text. This say, first file, this is what I can add file tag, then generate report only for that file, or else two files, whichever. Autopsy 4.14, this version is a very, very good. And I'm generating report. I have selected only two image files. I'm generating report for this one. This is a report. You can see here. This is a report. It is tagged images too, and it is generating. Okay, we can generate report for that one. This other is magnet forensics. This is also, I think, trial version. You can register if you are in official organization, any government organization, or period registration official, you can register on your department name, and you can they will through your mail you can get the software. That is 30 days trial version is there. You can use this also. It's 30 days trial version. You can practice. You can get used to that within 30 days. Axiom magnet forensics within that. Axiom process is there. Axiom examine is there. Both you will get it. Axiom process say one query was there in one of the case. Does they want? But operating system, it was installed in that. Only one query was there. This right side, after imaging, uploading in the magnet Axiom, operating system information separate folder is there. Just I clicked it, right side, it contains everything. Date of installation, what is the operating system, date of installation, version, everything is there, right side. This Axiom, regarding if it is anything internet related, this is very good. This application is very good. Internet related, internet we call internet artifacts. If it is queries related to internet, this magnet Axiom, this is very good application. This log files, say, which date the initial, the oldest file was there, created, then location, then when the same file was renamed, deleted, everything you can get, log file analysis. This option is there in magnet Axiom, it is also there, but here, the only thing is this actually, it will be highlighted in left side, user friendly. FTK is also there. There are some more tools also. Any doubts? Hello? Hello?
Sir, we have many questions from participant side.
Okay.
Shall I, 1 minute?
Yes, madam.
What is the best open source forensic tool for mobile device?
Open source?
Yes.
Open source, you may get for mobile devices. XRO is there, you may get a trial version for maybe 3 months, I think. XRO is an oxygen forensic tool. UFED you will not get. UFED it is a licensed version. Oxygen forensic suit is there. I think 30 days or 90 days. Now they have extended, I think 90 days. Oxygen forensic suit, you have to register. Trial version they may give. Oxygen forensic suit. And CDAC, it is for SIM extractor mobile. Even minimum, you will get a genuine report generation for live data of even latest one also. CDAC mobile edit, it is there. CDAC random. Mobile edit is there. SIM extractor, it is there. Both generated by CDAC random only. This product, it is cheaper, maybe 20 to 30,000 SIM extractor may cost a little bit higher for mobile edit. These both is actually product of CDAC random. And others, you may get the trial version, ma'am. Trial version of what is that? Oxygen forensic suit. 30 days or 90 days. In case it is actually quite costly, but it is a best tool for mobile. Any other query, madam?
Yes, thank you. Another question. Suppose if the data or hard disk formatted several times, is it still recoverable, the data, sir, through forensic tools?
Yes, formatted several times. 90% if one tool doesn't help, other tool will help. Worst case is, we can say 100% on Tonso sector, data was present. Most of the time, we used to get retrieved if it is not overwritten, repeat. One thing I'll tell you, there is difference between formatting and wiping. Wiping, it is gone. There is zero in all the bits will be the sector. We cannot do anything. But if you are intelligent, you will wipe it before they stage the hard disk. If formatted, most of the time, either if in case it's not supporting, I'll go for magnet axiom or else autopsy. One or the other, some way, I'll get some data from each and every tool. Not that I cannot guarantee that we can get 100% of all 100% data. That is if it is formatted again and again. Difficulty is in retrieving overwritten data. If it is overwritten, it is difficulties there. That is fact. One thing, we will get the file name and location, not the content of the data. That is there, madam. What restrictions are there? It is okay. Not that everything is 100% possible.
And one more question, it's not technically one. one of the researcher has asked, is there any faculty internship for 10 days in your organization for security oriented researchers?
Security oriented researchers, faculty internship?
Yes.
For okay, security. Sorry.
Sir, your voice is getting.
Hello, madam.
Can you repeat the question, madam? Yes, sir. Can you stop the sharing, sir? Yes, yes. Yes, let me. Yes, sir. Now you can proceed, sir. Okay, yes, yes, madam. Let me just, I would like to please repeat the question.
One minute.
Question is, any faculty internship is available in your organization for 10 days?
Yes, yes, you, I think officially you may put up a letter to our director, then it is possible. You may put up a letter to our director, Central Forensic Science Laboratory, Hyderabad. I think everything on online itself, you will get the complete address. Then you have to put up an official letter to our director. Then it will be, then you may borrow the HOD of the digital forensic division, then it will be there, reply will be there. I need okay. to put up that it is possible. At least 10 days attachment will be there, digital forensic, where you can get involved with all the forensic tools.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for giving insight on different digital forensic tools. Really, it was an interactive session. You also explained about the different hashing techniques, axiom process, and MKS, about MKS tools and all. It was an interactive session, but participants also have just come up with the question as whether they'll be getting an opportunity to do their internship program. It's a way of helping them to do their research at your place. It's a really, this is a different question which we have faced for the past, past 11 sections, sessions. Really, it was an interactive session. Thank you. Thank you for accepting our request and being with us for the last 1.5 hours. For just explaining us about the different tools. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.